Well, Mr. Chairman, I will not press Mr. Chu anymore since he's determined not to answer anyway. Okay. Anyway, once the Anti-Money Laundering Council would investigate this matter, all these financial transactions will be revealed anyway.
So let us proceed.
Yes, Mr. Chairman. And for that matter, I move that we notify the Anti-Money Laundering Council to investigate the financial transactions, the bank transactions rather, of the Binay law firm and the companies of Mr. Chu and Mr. Laureano, so that we can see the flow of money from one hand to the other. I so move, Mr. Chairman.
Mr. Chair, just on that relationship, just on that issue, may we also ask the SEC and the PSE, kasi I'm really concerned about yung galaw nung pera. And if we do it here and we show it, and you know, as I said, the Binay money and the Chu, they will say we're biased. But if it is the agencies by law that have been told to do it this way, no, then we should they should come out with a very objective findings, yung may forensic accounting, no, or yung investigation na gagawin nila. So aside from the Anti-Money Laundering Council, the BIR, SEC, and the PSE should look into this, Mr. Chair. And we will submit to them the documents we have.
But specifically, Mr. Chairman, I move that we invite Commissioner Kim Henares and along with the tax documents, tax returns of the persons that we would submit later to the committee, Mr. Chairman.
Okay, on the second motion, I will grant the second motion that we invite Commissioner Henares as well as Sec. Chair Herbosa to the next hearing. But on the first motion, can we study that motion further? Because maybe it would be a proper recommendation in a committee report should we have findings to justify the recommendation. Okay, so.
Okay. Yes, Mr. Chairman. Anyway, I think motu proprio the AMLAC, I'm sure they're monitoring the proceedings and they would be investigating these companies and these offices on their own volition.
Mr. Chair, before we give the Attorney Bautista the floor, may I ask him, will you be speaking for yourself or for Vice President Binay?
Let's put him because under oath first.
Okay, go ahead.
May the Director General administer the oath to Attorney Bautista.
Thank you, Chairman.
Kindly raise your right hand. Do you swear or affirm to tell the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth in this proceeding?
Yes, I do.
Thank you.
Okay, Mr. Chair, thank you very much. I asked that question because I'm only acceding to having a person who's not invited speak here if he's going to speak for the Vice President. But if he's going to speak for himself, it will be useless. You know, you can't have 100 million Filipinos speaking here with their opinion. May Facebook na lang, may radio, TV naman. So, Attorney Bautista, will you be speaking for the Vice President or for yourself?
I will be speaking, Mr. Chair and distinguished senators, because my name was dropped a while ago.
Mr. Chair, your name was drafted because you were in the media saying that there is an OPLAN stop nog-nog.
Yes.
And that is fair game because you said sa media.
Yes.
But not everyone mentioned here is given the chance to speak here just because he said, she said, she said. There's no allegations of any wrongdoing. There's no allegations of anomaly. Well, your privacy wasn't violated. So if you want to speak here, sir.
Mr. Senator, you asked me to come here and...
No, I didn't, sir. You raised your hand and you stood up. So I said you're welcome.
I was welcome.
If we're going to get something substantive. But that's what I'm saying, sir. I will allow you to speak and I will move that we allow you to speak.
Yes.
If you will speak for the Vice President, if you will speak for yourself, who cares?
But hello,
I mean, it's not part of an investigation. It's
okay,
not part
we are pressed for time, and we welcome actually the Attorney Bautista
Thank
to
you,
join
Mr. Chair.
Us.
Thank you.
So, can we just give him limited time to
sure,
to
respond? Mr. Chair? But let me.
I just, Mr. Chair.
Just to respond to that,
yes, Mr. Chair.
To what you heard, which made you approach the hearing. You know, okay.
First of all, Mr. Chair.
With that commitment, go ahead, Panyero.
Yes, thank you very much, Mr. Chairman. But I would just like to clarify that I am not speaking here because I am being tolerated. I think this, the trust of the committee hearings, I've been here for the second time. I was here during the last hearing of this subcommittee to see for myself the proceedings that are being conducted here because the Vice President has refused all invitation of this subcommittee. And I wanted to see for myself the reasons and the basis for the refusal of the Vice President to come here. And I have affirmed last hearing and this hearing the reasons why. It was all very clear to everybody. Pagka ang nagsasalita, Nestor Mercado, no interruption. Dire-direcho. Pagka nagsasalita, Mr. Chu, cross-examination. I have heard two witnesses this morning until this afternoon testifying in this subcommittee. Mr. Mercado and Senator Trill at Senator Cayetano, complete with the PowerPoint presentation. This was not an investigation in aid of legislation. Bakit ho merong mga documents?
Attorney Bautista, yes, Mr. Chair. Already raised in the jurisdictional challenge, already yes. Ruled on.
Mr. Chair,
can you react to the stop yes. Log 2016 which made you rise for yes. The chair?
Oh. Attorney Bautista, yes, lahat ng sinabi, lahat
may
ng sinasabi.
May I now respond?
We are pressed for time. We are using the session all 3 o'clock.
And that is the reason why I'm speaking.
Yeah.
Attorney Bautista, I'm just
no,
saying.
No, no, no. I think, Mr. Senator, I have been recognized by the chair.
Let's hear, Senator Cayetano.
Ang sinasabi ko lang po, kaya namin kayo ni Winel welcome dito. Number one, akala ko finally, we will hear something under oath from the spokesman.
Well, you will, Mr. Senator.
Can I
finish?
Will. Sir, can I finish?
You
sir?
Will.
Can I finish?
Yes.
Okay. From the spokesman of the Vice President, because sa media, pabago-bago statements ninyo.
Ano po bang pabago-bago, Mr. Senator? Wala hong nagbabago doon.
Sir, you said I can finish.
Excuse me.
Can I finish?
Let's have an orderly discussion.
Yes, Mr.
Actually, you are a resource person here.
Thank you very much, Mr. Chairman.
So, let's have a dialogue.
I appreciate that very much,
Mr. Chairman. Since pabago-bago, sir, ang statement, iba ho yung nagkakaharapan. That's why sabi ko, kahit Makati City Hall magpahiring, ako pupunta. Para malaman ng tao yung difference sa pumayag mag-imbestiga hindi. But you were mentioned in connection with Oplan Nogdog which is non-existent. And sir, lahat ng sinabi mo dito, sinabi mo na sa media at lahat yan nasagot. Hahaba lang tayo. Ang mga kakampi ni Senate ni Vice President, welcome dito. Welcome po i-cross-examine si Mr. Chu. Welcome po i-cross-examine si Vice Mayor, sila ang ayaw pumunta. Si Vice President po mismo pwede pumunta dito. He can cross-examine me. He can cross-examine them. Now, if you wanna do it, you have to speak for him, not for yourself. I respect your opinion.
But that is not allowed by the rules, Mr. Chair.
But we can move to waive the rules. We can waive the rules if the President, lahat ng dahilan sinabi na ng Vice President. Ayaw niya lang magpaliwanag.
Ang
8 out of
po,
10 Filipinos.
Mr.
Anyway,
Senator,
I will finish, Mr. Chairman, so that you can answer.
Yes.
Please stick to the topic of which is the Oplan Nogno.
Yes.
And then if you're willing to speak for the Vice President, I will listen.
Yes.
If not, then can we stick to the topic?
Okay. Okay, Mr. Chair.
Go ahead.
And distinguished senators. We stumbled on this demolition plan. Codenamed Operation Plan SN16, Stop Nognog 2016. How did we find out about it? Kasi po, even before the start of this subcommittee hearing, a congressman of the Liberal Party who has made a career out of bashing the Vice President by the name of Egay Irise came out in the media. Sabi po niya, watch out. Local politicians from Makati are coming out and are going to file a plunder case against the Vice President. Well, our question was, how did he know? Unless, of course, the local politician will be coming from the Liberal Party. But no, the local politician, Attorney Bundal, comes from the Nacionalista Party. And then later on, Mr. Mercado, another local politician, also came from the Nationalista Party. Ngayon, pagkatapos po ni Mr. Irise sabihin yan, eto na si Mr. Bundal, filing a plunder complaint against the Vice President. And immediately thereafter, Senator Trillanes filed a resolution to investigate the Makati City Hall Building 2. O yan na.
And rightly so, yun. And rightly so, Congressman, Attorney J.B. Bautista.
Thank you, thank you. Rightly so. And we were hoping that the investigation will focus on the Makati City Hall Building 2. If that were the case, Mr. Chair, then this hearing would have been fair. But that was not the case. Pagkatapos pong i-create ang subcommittee at nag-umpisa na hearing, eto na po, lumabas na si Ginoong Nestor Mercado. Lahat na ho ng mga bintang inilabas na dito. Wala na kinalaman sa Makati City Hall Building 2. Eto na, ang pinag-uusapan na ho natin dito, Rosario Property. Sabi niya 350 hectares. Sabi niya it's Hacienda Binay. Sabi niya air condition daw yung piggery dahil ayaw maamoy ni Mrs. Binay yung amoy ng mga baboy. Oh. Asan ang proof para sabihin niya yon? Asan ang patunay niya except for a video, an aerial video of the property na sabi niya kasama siya sa helicopter? Yung pala, hindi naman. Then we were able to obtain a copy of the flight plan. Ang may-ari ng chopper, Mr. Zamora, Buddy Zamora, and among those who took part in the flight, one of those, and I suspect, Mr. Chair, distinguished senators, he was the one who probably took the photo because he's a graphic artist under the employ of Senator Cayetano. What was he doing there? I thought that this committee is supposed to hear evidence, elicit evidence from witnesses appearing before it. That's the reason for the subpoena. Why are the senators the ones gathering evidence? Kayo na po ang nagpapakita eh ng mga PowerPoint presentation. Pagkatapos ng PowerPoint presentation ni Mr. Mercado, PowerPoint presentation ni Senator Trillanes. Pagkatapos ng PowerPoint presentation ni Trillanes, PowerPoint presentation ni Senator Cayetano. O ngayon naman, ganun na naman. PowerPoint presentation of Senator Cayetano. Yeah. That is why, Mr.
I think you made
Mr. Senator,
point, huh?
Yes, that is why
wind up, please,
we have been, Mr. Chair. That is why we have been able to come to this conclusion that after all we've gathered, and mind you, the Vice President has friends, even in the Liberal Party, even in the Nationalista Party. That's the reason why one of his spokesmen now come from the Nationalista Party. Kaya ho yung mga bagay na yan, nalalaman namin.
So yung Oplan Nognog inimbento niyo?
Hindi ho, hindi namin inimbento yan.
Saan
yun
saan galing?
Sa yan basis, sinasabi na nga niya yung basis niya. So
yes.
That's it. So,
no, that's the basis for them.
Mr. Chairman,
you said you came to the conclusion. I'm saying yung name ng Oplan, saan yun nabunot yun?
Okay, hindi namin binunot yun. Napag-alaman namin yun.
Saan po?
I will not tell you sino nagsabi sa amin.
Secret, secret.
Of course.
Okay, that's
so anyway,
Mr.
Po,
Senator,
no, it's okay. I will respect
you
that.
You cannot. Yes, of course.
And kung
of
meron course. Bank secrecy, meron din na nognog secrecy, okay lang po. You've made your point, Mr. Chair.
Yes.
But let me just put on the record, Mr. Chair. Ang rules ng Blue Ribbon Committee, panahon ni Erap Estrada, panahon ni Cory Aquino, panahon ni FVR, panahon po ni Gloria Macapagal Arroyo, hindi nagbago. Yung ganitong style ng pagpapakita ng ebidensya as a form of question, hindi po nagbago. Hindi to impeachment court. Nalilito po ang ating kumpanyero. Yung pong mga senador, nung panahon ni GMA, yung mga pro-GMA, hindi tinatanong ang mga kabinete. Yung mga anti, binibira, tinatanong. Kasama po doon na nagrarally si VP Binay na sinasabi, magsabi sila ng totoo. Kasama si VP Binay nagsabing, si Garci dapat mag-appear kahit po gunigrill namin. Kasama si VP Binay nagsabing, dapat yan po sa fertilizer scam, kasama siya. So ngayon po, na kayo na po nakasalang, ang Vice President, binago na at tinangal. But anyway, we told our story, you said our story. I don't deny, Mr. Chair.
To that?
No, that was already a response to you. Mr. Chair,
yes.
Let me ask, kasi we only have 10 minutes and we've already said both sides. No? Sinabi nyo, Bakit kami nagpalipad? Sinabi namin, pinalipad namin because I want to verify. Sinabi na ni Vice President, Vice Mayor, hindi naman siya lumipad. Sabi niya nagpalipad. So, let the people decide. But this is my question, Attorney JV. Kanina pinakita ko yung statement mo na 2010, ang mga Binay binenta na yung kanilang farm. Tama? Tama po? Binenta na daw nila nung 2010?
If that's my statement, yes.
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 So, between 2010 and 2013 or now, hindi na sa kanila yon.
Between 2010 and 2013?
Between the time na binenta hanggang ngayon?
Let me clarify that. The information that we were able to release to the media,
okay,
through me as a spokesman.
Okay po.
Senator, you've been a spokesman yourself,
yes,
di ba, for
yes,
Manny Villar.
Yes.
Alam nyo, na these kinds of information come fast, di ba?
Yes.
And you are not in a position to verify all matters except those which you will come out in the media publicly. Okay.
Okay.
Now, when the Vice President became, when Jejomar Binay became
Vice
President, nag-divest po siya.
So, ang natira na lang, anong natira na lang po? Yung lease nila sa Orchid Farm?
The lease.
Okay. Pero madalas pa rin po sila doon sa farm.
Alam mo, Mr. Senator, I don't even know eh. Kasi I have never stepped foot on that so-called farm.
Pero sa orchids lang po, no? Ang sabi niya, hindi na sa kanila yung Kew Garden.
Kung yun po ang sinabi ni Vice President, then that's it. Yun ang sinabi ni Vice President.
Can we show slide number 35? Yeah. Ito po ay hindi si Alang Cayetano nagsasabi. Ito po ay Asian Dragon Magazine, March to April 2010. No? Ang sabi, binenta noong 2010, pero ang sinabi, sa kanila lang daw po, ay yung lang pong piggery lang daw at saka yung ano. Pero tignan nyo po, ang pa-interview ni Mrs. Binay ay yung buong farm ang sa kanila. Next slide, please. Ayan po mga pictures nila, all over, pati yung Koi Garden. Hindi nga po kita sa ano yan eh, sa helicopter, kaya nagulat po ako na meron palang ganyan pala kaganda, no? Pati sa Koi Garden, Koi Pond. No? Yan yung Asian Dragon Magazine. Ang sabi po ni Linda Lim, join others avowed plant lovers to visit Miss Doctora Elinita's Batangas Farm. My first thought when I saw the farm was, gosh, it was not what anyone would expect. It looked more like a resort. Okay? Yun po yung sinabi ng author. No? Next slide po. Nang 2012, ang Philippine Orchid Society po ay meron pong handaan dun din po sa farm ginawa at nakalagay, Dr. Elinita Binay's farm. Yan po. Nandyan po yung date. Ayan po yung invitation mismo. Sa mismong website pa yan, okay, ng Philippine Orchid. Next slide, please. Ito po ay sa AKCUPI Directors and Staff Visit Facebook to Dr. Elinita Binay, wife of our Vice President in Batangas City. Okay, next slide. Rosario Batangas, yes. Next slide. Ayan po, our host, Dr. Elinita. Wala po yan sa garden. Ayan po, nasa bahay yan, no? Sa rest okay. House. At napakarami po nito. Masasayang lang. Let me finish lang
apo,
po.
Apo.
Masasayang lang kasi oras kong lahat. Pero ayan po, may date naman ng Facebook eh, di ba?
Okay.
June 18, 2012. Next po. Ayan. Asian Kennel Club Union of the Philippines yan, no? Ayan, sa swimming pool mismo, nakapunta sila. Nakapag sabi, sige, dyan kayo. Okay. Next. Ito po yung buong grupo. Ayan po si Mrs. Binay. At sa susunod po, ayan, kasama na rin po ang ating Vice President sa picture, no? Pero nung pinakita ko po to sa ibang mga witnesses na madalas dun sa farm, kasi ang mga asawa pala ng mga mayor between the last 3 years, dinadala nila dyan. At sinasabi, farm namin to, pinapaikot sila. Nangangampanya eh, no? So, sabi ko, ganito ba usually itsura? Sabi na, hindi sir. Usually yan si VP Binay, mahilig mag-ano yan, magparang militar o parang safari, iikot kami dyan. No? So, nagpahanap ako ng picture. No? So, next slide. So, ayan po. No? Tatlong grupo daw parati yan. Yung mga politiko, mga militar, yung pangatlo, iba-ibang group, mga party list, mga kaliwa, etc. Binadala niya dyan. Okay. Next slide. Ayan po. Ayan po yung koi farm, siya mismo nagpapakita. Marami pa akong picture na talagang nakaturo. At nahiya lang po ako dahil yung iba po nakakayang pakita kasi mga Liberal Party. Oh, okay. So kung sasabihin nyo na ito ay plot ng Liberal Party, bakit nandun sila sa bahay ni Binay? Okay. Next slide. Malamang may nasyonalista din, malamang may lahat ng ano.
Okay.
No, okay. So yan po ang tanong ko po, Attorney JV.
Opo.
Bilang spokesman ng presidente.
Opo, Senator.
Kung sinasabi po niya na hindi sa kanya.
Okay.
No, bilang spokesman ng ating vice presidente, kung sinasabi niyang hindi sa kanya. Bakit po lahat ng nagsasalita paikot ng farm sinasabi sa kanya? Bakit si Nanay Maria na nakita niyo po no na 86 po, 90 years old ang sinabi kay Binay mismo binenta? At bakit po between 2010 and 2013 all the acts of ownership si Binay pa rin nag-exercise?
Okay, may I respond?
Yes, of course.
Mr. Senator, you're a lawyer. None of these things that you have shown to this gallery and to national television will constitute evidence. Nagpakuha kang litrato, iyon na lupa, iyon na property. No, yung mga staff ni Senator, di ba? Are you lawyers? If you can prove
si,
na by
kung,
si,
kung
by,
madadala
by
si,
I'm sorry, Mr. Senator, but okay, I'm still explaining.
Mr. Chair.
May I just finish, Mr. Chairman? May I just finish?
Go ahead.
Mr. Chairman, I'll just interject a bit.
Senator, hindi po yun ang tanong ko sa witness eh.
Ano ha ang tanong?
Ang tanong ko,
ang tanong nyo, hindi ba?
Hindi po yun ang tanong. You're arguing for the Vice President. Lahat po ng pinakita namin ebidensya. Is that admissible evidence in court?
Yes, Attorney Cayetano?
Yes,
is that admissible
yes,
evidence?
Yes, it is. Yes, it is.
Then let us test
yes,
it.
Is.
Let us test
witness,
it.
Witness, witness.
Mr. Chair,
can you address the chair?
Yes, Mr. Chairman. The trouble is I have not been allowed to finish.
No, Mr.
The question was so long. It was kilometric. And yet I am not allowed to finish.
Senators are allowed to interrupt.
Mr. Chair, the question was... Mr. Chairman, the question is...
Yes, Mr. Senator.
Hindi tanong kung evidence o hindi. Si Nanay Maria, narinig mo kanina, pag dinala natin sa korte yon, witness yon sa kanya yung lupa eh. Hindi po yun ang tanong. At hindi kita din pinapa-comment.
There was no evidence that the property owned by Nanay Maria is the same property that is now being the subject matter of this inquiry.
Yung po yung motor pool ng Sanchamp. Channel 2 mismo nag-verify. Ngayon, kung hindi ka naniniwala sa Channel 2, huwag ka magpa-interview sa kanila.
There is no testimony to that effect.
Mr. Chair,
this is a simple...
Mr. Chairman,
yes, anyway, Mr. Chair, that's not
point of order.
That's
point of order, Mr. Chairman. Attorney Bautista, let us have a dialogue. Okay,
yes, sir, but if this is going to be the way...
Okay lang, okay.
I'll just manifest something.
I think we have given... Tony J.B. Bautista is 15 minutes, and I think he felt good about it already.
Yes.
And
No, I don't.
Tony J.B. Bautista, you're on a very short leash.
Yeah. Mr. Chair.
Okay. Ganito ha. Panyero, Tony Bautista.
Yes, Mr. Chair.
The chairman of the Mother Committee, Senator T.G. Gingona.
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Has said that he will extend an invitation to your client, the Vice President.
We will graciously wait
for him to appear before the Mother Committee. So please relay the invitation to him.
Mr. Chairman, that is a welcome development. I think that is one way of being able to break out from this kind of an investigation. And the Vice President will graciously consider the invitation once.
General invitation pa lang yun, the details to follow.
Is it a formal invitation befitting the office of the Vice President?
Just give him the advance info, but there will of course be a formal invitation.
I will do that, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you for your time, Panyero.
Thank you very much.
Attorney Certeza, I promise you airtime if you want to respond.
Mr. Chair, just let me put on the record that hindi nga masagot yung tanong ko na bakit kung sinasabing hindi sa kanilat na benta, lahat ng rights of an owner ay ine-exercise ng mga Binay over this farm. Supposedly, sabi niya, spokesman din ako. Nung spokesman po ako, never ako nagsisinungaling sa aking principal. At sinasabi ko sa principal ko, sir, magpaliwanag tayo. At bumabalik ako sa kanya para magpaliwanag. So ang tanong ko lang naman, kung hindi sa Binay yon, bakit lahat doon alam si Binay? Bakit yung may-ari ng titulo sa Binay? Bakit lahat ng litrato at ang dami pa nagpapadala na may petsa. Sabi, sir, buti pa ho nung naging agri-tourism, ang turista lang ho dun, Binay, at kung sinong dalhin nila. Lahat ng iba, bawal. If I go there now, hindi ako papasukin. Pero if the vice president, his family goes there now, dire-diretso, may golf cart na naghihintay na dadalhin sila sa rest house. Yun po ang mga ano. So, kaya yun lang po.
Can I answer?
Yun ang tanong ko.
Why? I was not allowed eh.
Hintayin na natin si Vice President mismo ang sasagot kung saan po siya
pupunta. Yes, but the comments are
very, he was allowed to answer, but he doesn't want to answer.
No,
you were allowed to answer except that iba yung sinasagot mo.
The answer is,
okay, answer please.
Pictures will not show ownership.
So, that's not true.
Ownership.
So, hindi po totoo. Hindi po totoong they're acting like they're the owners.
They are not acting like owners. They invited.
They're always there.
So what if they're always there?
Ah, so thank you for admitting that they're always there.
What are the attributes of ownership? Okay.
Thank you for that. For admitting that they're always there.
Okay. Sandali. Let's put some order. Okay.
Okay.
Are you through? Okay. Anyway, all of what you've stated are on record. Now, the subcommittee will consider your opinions.
Thank you very much, Mr. Chairman.
Okay. Thank you very much, Mr. Chairman. I'd just like to manifest in relation to the question I asked earlier to Attorney Martin Subido. The Vice President yesterday in his interview admitted that he is a member, he is a partner of the Subido law firm, and he is on leave of absence. So that's on record. You're not, I'm not asking you. Okay, for the record, Mr. Chairman.
Attorney Certeza, you were invited by Senator Trillanes to also join us, just in case you want to respond to to that information where your name was mentioned.
Thank you very much, Mr. Chair. I was asked a while back to be a resource speaker also, and I'd just like to inform the honorable senators that yes, I am a partner in the Subido, Pagente, Certeza, Mendoza, and Dina. In fact, I owe everything to the father of Martin Subido. Because, by the way, Dean Ponciano Subido is now dead. No? But he was the one very instrumental for this, for me to become a lawyer. And that is the reason why I am a part of the law firm. Now, if the chairman may just allow me maybe to make a small contribution to the heated arguments that has just transpired. One of the points that I heard a while back was the question about Mr. Tony Chu being claiming that he is the owner, and during the course of the proceedings, he was taken to task because he is not the registered owner yet. I just wish to give my 2 cents worth, if I may. Pag tayo po kasi kung minsan bumibili tayo ng property, kung minsan po naglo-loan tayo sa banko, hindi po ba? And when we take out a loan, we use, let's say, for me, I have a car that is purchased on loan from the bank. Wala naman ho sa pangalan ko yung titulo. Ngunit, pag tinanong po ako ng tao, sa'yo ba yung coaching yan? Sasabihin ko po, opo, akin yan, sasakyan na yan. So there may be times that you are not the registered owner, but you can rightfully claim that you are indeed the owner. So yun lang po.
In that context.
Okay. Yes po. Okay, so, salamat po.
Mr. Chair, just to even the opinion of, or to clarify that, ang bangko po, hindi kayo pa utangin unless sure siya kung sino may-ari ng kotse na pinagbilan mo, then you surrender certain documents to them. So pag sinabing akin na yan, pero loan sa banko, this is a different case. Kasi yung pinagbilan ni Mr. Chu, hindi alam kung dami ni BP Binay o hindi. Because they did not check the titles and other people were saying. But in the same argument ni Attorney Certeza, minsan sabihin mong akin kahit hindi. Yun nga ang issue dito, sir. Kay VP Binay ba to o hindi? And so far, there's been loads of evidence presented, but Mr. Binay himself, your client, refuses to answer these questions. Sa media, panay generalities. No? Ayaw niyang sagutin point by point. That's why, in my effort, despite advice ng marami, wag mo nang banggitin si Mr. Bautista, wag mo dalhin dito, but uhaw na akong marinig ang side ninyo. Diba na, na paano ka kumita ng 44, ano yung 44 million, ano ang binivest mo, kay Mr. Gregorio mo ba binenta o sa Agri Fortuna, etc. Hindi po masagot dito eh. That's why the vice mayor is not being grilled here. It's not because we take his word hook, line, and sinker. Because he gives hard evidence and we follow it. Mismong yung sinasabi niya, chinecheck ko sa SEC lahat. Chinecheck ko, kaya nga yung staff ko pa ang tumingin dun sa helicopter. At yung sinasabi ni Mr. Chu is my opportunity to test. Now, if the vice president simply comes here and follows the people 8 out of 10, tapos to. Kung gusto niyo, tingin niyo, ako hindi dapat magtanong dahil bias. O sige, si Senator Pimentel na si Senator Trillanes magtatanong. Ang problema, nagtatago eh. Ayaw mag-appear dito. And that's the bottom line here, Mr. President. Lastly, Mr. Chair, no? Mr. Chair, we will be wrapping up the hearing on the Makati City parking building, no, or building 2. And we will be making our recommendations and report. So that it may not be said that we will not consider other evidence. Kung hindi pupunta ang Vice President, may we ask his lawyers who are here today to feel free to submit your evidence so that naman the committee can see both sides. But if you will not submit and you will not send people to testify, lahat ng taga Makati, absent ngayon, hindi nagpapakita, do not blame us if we make conclusions based on the evidence that was pointed out in this hearing. That is precisely why I showed that video. Because despite the fact that she did not testify here, at least alam nyo and you can respond. But instead that, they want to engage us in a shouting match. Punto per punto po, himayin natin dito. But the fact remains, Attorney JV, that the hill marks, the testimony of the Vice Mayor, the link between the Makati City Building and the farm is that hill marks daw ang gumawa dun. At yun daw ang pinangbayad. Kaya sila nagtataas ng presyo. If we were listening intently to all of our hearings, kaya napunta sa Rosario. Hindi na biglang liko yan. Hindi na ligaw yan. It is part of the hearing dun sa Makati building overpriced. So anyway, Mr. Chair, I know we have to adjourn, but we will welcome that evidence and we will welcome them to attend. Ang problema, ayaw nila mag-attend.
One more question to, was it you, Attorney Subido, who said that and quoted in media that the Vice President sold JCB Farms in 2010 and he netted 10 million pesos from the sale?
He netted 10 million and then the carrying cost is around 7 point something million, Your Honor.
What is the meaning of carrying cost?
Of the improvements and other assets that he sold, Your Honor. So the net income is around 2 plus million, which was reflected in his ITR.
So yun yung nakikita po natin mga structures dun sa piggery na halos ilan yung 20 buildings.
Not all, Your Honor.
Not
just,
all?
I understand, just six of those.
Because yung the rest are not his.
The rest are Agri Fortunas, Your Honor.
Agri Fortunas. So that's the case. So, Attorney Certeza, do you want to respond?
May I respectfully request for just a short response?
Yes, yes.
With all due respect to Senator Cayetano, I wish to respond. First and foremost, he made a statement po na the Makati officials ay nagtatago, quote-unquote. Yesterday po, Senator, I made sure to ask everyone if anyone received a subpoena. Wala po kasi.
Attorney, can we respond to that? We didn't issue subpoenas to them because Mayor Junjun, when we allowed him not to attend, promised that all his department heads will come here. No? And then at the middle of the hearing, nung sa testimony nila nabubuko yung mga overprice, bigla silang nag-disappear. So nagpadala ng subpoena, unfortunately, 5 minutes late, hindi na tinanggap. So kung gusto naman po nila pumunta, sir, pwede naman sila pumunta si Mr. Bautista, to his credit, no? Di naman siya pinatawag, nandito siya, nabanggit, pumunta dito. So kung gusto ng administrador ng Makati, gusto ng budget officer pumunta, they're welcome. But the fact is, we have 4 hearings, lahat sila disappear.
At any rate, if I may respond, that is what I told them. I told them, kung may subpoena, sabihin niyo po at sasamahan ko kayo. On the other side, Your Honor, with respect to the fact that the absence of the vice president here. As his counsel, we have discussed this several times already. And with all due respect to the subcommittee, we felt that it is not the proper forum. Now, of course, the chair has already ruled on this, but only to explain why the vice president is not appearing is because we believe, Your Honors, that the way the hearings are being conducted, it already presupposes that he is guilty of all these wrongdoings. At any rate, Your Honors, you have already made a decision on
this. The same request that you relate to the Vice President, the manifestation of the Chairman, Chairman Gingona, that the,
yes,
mother,
Your Honor,
the Mother Committee will be the one inviting him.
Makakadating po, Apo. Your Honor.
Apo, and then, okay, Mr. Chu, one last question. So, since from your point of view, you were already, or San Champ was already the owner of the entire property, sabi niyo, owner kayo, did you book it as an asset already? In the financial statements of the corporation.
Your Honor, hindi pa po pwede natin i-book yan hanggang
kasi,
hindi pa fully completed yung payment of the entire 446 million pesos.
Hindi mo pwedeng i-book naman yung counterpart na liabilities mo, yung outstanding checks mo?
Hindi po standard practice yun na magpalaki ng liability sa balance sheet.
De, yung assets mo, lumaki din.
Well, hindi pa po natin kinoconsider for...
So, sa mata mo, owner ka na, pero hindi mo i-reflect sa financial statement?
We will be reflected in as soon as possible.
You mentioned also that in 2014, some of the tax decks were already transferred to Sanchamp.
Yes.
So in addition to the 11 million down payment, have you cleared some of your checks? Outstanding checks?
There's a pending check that will be cleared by end of the year, Your Honor.
Only one check? One pending check?
Yes.
In the amount of?
If I'm not mistaken, it's 44 million pesos.
44 million because they complied with their obligations,
yes.
to... So is there a timetable for Mr. Sinobito?
Gregorio. Yes.
To deliver his deliverables?
Yes.
Is there a timetable?
There's a required prescribed period of 2 years.
2 years. What will happen if he fails?
Well, we will have to look at the legal options.
Ah, it's not in the contract? The effect of failure to deliver the deliverables is not in the contract?
Well, the simplest thing is we will not pay the balance.
Okay, what will happen?
Well,
rescinded. The contract is rescinded.
Yeah, rescinded.
Sa ulian.
Yeah.
Magsasaulian kayo. Are you sure?
If there's no turnover of the title,
right.
And then we don't pay, then nothing will.
Yeah, you return everything to him, even the possession, and he will return everything to you, include all your payments.
Yes.
Tama po ba yun?
Yes.
Yung understanding niya?
Yes, Your Honor.
Any more questions?
Senator Kaitan.
Mr. Chair, just before we wrap up and go. Mr. Chu, doon po kayo mismo nagpa-interview, no, sa Rosario Property sa Channel 2?
Yes, Your Honor.
Sinasabi kasi kanina walang aircon yung sa Babuyan. Alin ang pinakita niyong building? Yung malapit sa garden o yung malayo? Yung malayo, di ba? Yung nasa likod ang pinakita niya.
Lahat po pinakita.
Lahat pinakita. Pero yung main building hindi niyo pinakita?
Lahat po. Pati...
Yung main building, nakasara, di ba? May ginagawa daw.
Ah, hindi ho, lahat
yung may, yung, not yung Babuyan, yung main house.
Ah, nandun po si Henry. Nakita
sa main house.
Ah, lahat,
okay.
Ho na...
So, in-open nyo po lahat?
Lahat.
So, if you opened it all sa media, you wouldn't mind opening it up sa Senate at mag-ocular tayo doon?
Yeah.
Okay. So, Mr. Chairman, at the proper time, no, to verify certain facts and everything,
yes.
And with the cooperation of Mr. Chu, so I thank him for coming here today and we appreciate you facing the Senate.
Maraming salamat po din sa pagkakataon na ito na mailatag ko rin yung mga puntos ko.
Dr. Llanes, anything more?
Mr. Chairman, can we do that ocular inspection well tomorrow? Can we do that? Baka makapag-impake pa eh. So,
may mga schedule.
That's correct, Mr. Chairman.
Hindi. I would like to correct.
Available, yeah.
Alam niyo, no, just to
Just to show kung paano nagbabago ito si Mr. Tony Chu, sinabi sa akin ni Henry Umaga Diaz, when he was interviewing me, I asked him kasi dahil he was getting my reaction, he was made to access all the areas except the main house. It was closed. So, huwag kang magsisinungaling again, Mr. Tony Chu.
Clarification, Your Honor. Wala pong area na i-prohibit natin siya pumasok. So, kung mangyari po lamang na sa darating na visit, pakisama po natin si Henry para mapatunayan natin na kung sino ang nagsisinungaling.
So, since you're the owner, anyway, so you're giving permission for an ocular inspection by the members of the subcommittee?
Okay.
Tomorrow.
Welcome, Your Honor.
So, the office of Senator Trillanes will coordinate with you for tomorrow's ocular inspection.
Alam naman po nila yung lugar. Thank you.
Okay, anything more? So,
and one last point. Kasi si Mr. Tony Chu has been mentioning about a contribution of 150,000 pesos sa media. Now, I'm having that piece of information checked, ano, dun sa aking statement sa COMELEC and including my staff. Pero sa akin, ito lang. Kahit binigyan mo ako ng 1 million, hindi ibig sabihin nun, pag nagkamali ka, i-absuelto ka. That's all, Mr. Chairman. Thank you.
And our next hearing is on October 30 and we will send a formal invitation as well as subpoena to those we expect to attend the hearing. So thank you very much for your attendance this day. Hearing is hereby suspended.
Have been told to do it this way, no? Then we should they should come out with a very objective findings, yung may forensic accounting, no? Or yung investigation na gagawin nila. So aside from the anti-money laundering council, the BIR, SEC, and the PSE should look into this, Mr. Chair. And we will submit to them the documents we have.
But specifically, Mr. Chairman, I move that we invite Commissioner Kim Henares and along with the tax documents, tax returns of the persons that we would submit later to the committee, Mr. Chairman.
Okay, on the second motion, I will grant the second motion that we invite Commissioner Henares as well as Sec. Chair Herbosa to the next hearing. But on the first motion, can we study that motion further? Because maybe it would be a proper recommendation in a committee report should we have findings to justify the recommendation. Okay, so.
Okay. Yes, Mr. Chairman. Anyway, I think motto proprio the AMLAC.
That I am not speaking here because I am being tolerated. I think this, the trust of the committee here is, I've been here for the second time. I was here during the last hearing of this subcommittee to see for myself the proceedings that are being conducted here. Because the Vice President has refused all invitation of this subcommittee. And I wanted to see for myself the reasons and the basis for the refusal of the Vice President to come here. And I have affirmed last hearing and this hearing the reasons why. It was all very clear to everybody. Pagka ang nagsasalita, Nestor Mercado, no interruption. Dire-direcho. Pagka nagsasalita, Mr. Chu, cross-examination. I have heard 2 witnesses this morning until this afternoon testifying in this subcommittee. Mr. Mercado and Senator Cayetano. Complete with the PowerPoint presentation.
I'm sure they're monitoring the proceedings and they would be investigating these companies and these offices on their own volition.
Mr. Chair, before we give the Attorney Bautista the floor, may I ask him, will you be speaking for yourself or for Vice President Binay?
Let's put him under oath first.
Okay, go ahead.
May the Director General administer the oath to Attorney Bautista.
Thank you, Chairman.
Kindly raise your right hand. Do you swear or affirm to tell the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth in this proceeding?
Yes, I do.
Thank you.
Okay, Mr. Chair, thank you very much. I asked that question because I'm only acceding to having a person who's not invited speak here if he's going to speak for the Vice President. But if he's going to be speak for himself, it will be useless. You know, you can't have 100 million Filipinos speaking here with their opinion. May Facebook na lang, may radio, TV naman. So, Attorney Bautista, will you be speaking for the Vice President or for yourself?
I will be speaking, Mr. Chair and distinguished senators, because my name was dropped a while ago.
Mr. Chair, your name was drafted because you were in the media saying that there is an OPLAN stop nog-nog.
Yes.
And that is fair game because you said sa media.
Yes.
But not everyone mentioned here is given the chance to speak here just because he said, she said, she said. There's no allegations of any wrongdoing. There's no allegations of anomaly. Well, your privacy wasn't violated. So if you want to speak here, sir.
Mr. Senator, you asked me to come here and...
No, I didn't, sir. You raised your hand and you stood up. So I said you're welcome.
I was welcome.
If we're going to get something substantive. But that's what I'm saying, sir. I will allow you to speak and I will move that we allow you to speak.
Yes.
If you will speak for the Vice President, if you will speak for yourself, who cares? I mean, it's not part of an investigation.
We are pressed for time, and we welcome actually Attorney Bautista
to join us. Thank you.
So, can we just give him limited time?
Yes.
To respond?
Mr. Chair. But let me.
Mr. Chair, just
to respond to that.
Yes, Mr. Chair.
To what you heard, which made you approach the hearing. You know, okay.
First of all, Mr. Chair.
With that commitment, go ahead, Panyero.
Yes. Thank you very much, Mr. Chairman. But I would just like to clarify.
Well, Mr. Chairman, I will not press Mr. Chu anymore since he's determined not to answer anyway. Okay. Anyway, once the Anti-Money Laundering Council would investigate this matter, all these financial transactions will be revealed anyway.
So let us proceed.
Yes, Mr. Chairman. And for that matter, I move that we notify the Anti-Money Laundering Council to investigate the financial transactions, the bank transactions rather, of the Binay law firm and the companies of Mr. Chu and Mr. Laureano, so that we can see the flow of money from one hand to the other. I so move, Mr. Chairman.
Mr. Chair. Just on that relationship, just on that issue, may we also ask the SEC and the PSE, kasi I'm really concerned about yung galaw ng pera. And if we do it here and we show it, and you know, as I said, the Binay money and the Chu, they will say we're biased. But if it is the agencies by law